So a problem I find most people trying to lose fat and lose weight is they're not counting their calories on a weekly basis, they're only counting them on a daily basis. And where most people, when I speak to them, quite often I'll find that they're pretty good for their regular diet in terms of the calorie intake. They may be inside the numbers that we're looking for them to achieve weight loss. Yes, they might need some changes to their macronutrient profile, stuff like that, but generally, people that are trying to lose weight, if you talk through what they would do on a regular basis to do so, their calories might even be slightly too low on that basis. But then what they don't really account for is their nights out that they have in that week. And if I break it down to a simple example, let's say someone's trying to cut their calories by 400 calories a day. So they're looking at 400 calories per day cut, and they're doing that consistently for 6 days of the week. So for 6 days a week, they're taking 400 calories off and going to deficit for those 400 calories. That means for those 6 days, they're 2,400 calories in deficit, which is a good start, which is going to help you to lose some fat and lose weight. But if you go out for a, let's say you go out for a meal, sometimes you go out for a meal, something as simple as a chicken burger and chips, that can be 1,500 calories. And if you add on top of that condiments like mayonnaise or ketchup, you can dip the chips in, stuff like that, maybe some glasses of wine, some other drinks, a dessert, you can be anywhere from, you know, 1,500 calories to 3,000, 3,500 calories. And if we say cut that in the middle, we say, let's say they've taken, you know, they had a meal, they had a few drinks, 2,500 calories over they are for that one day. That 2,500 calories will negate the other 6 days of being 400 calories below. So all of that hard work they've put in for those 6 days has been cut out by that one day of eating out, drinking out. And that's absolutely fine to go for a meal, absolutely fine to have drinks, some of that. But you need to expect that if you do that, you're not going to lose fat and you're not going to lose weight. And you need to accept that and just think, okay, it's not been wasted you cutting those calories out, because obviously if you hadn't cut those calories and you had 2,500 calories, then you'd have put on weight, you'd have put on fat. So there is some benefit to cutting your calories and then having a day where you have more calories, but you can't then expect to lose fat doing it that way. What you need to do is think about, okay, first of all, when you go out for a meal, when you go for drinks, you need to think about being a bit more savvy about the food choices you make, looking at the lower calorie options, looking at better choices on the menu than you maybe would make normally, and also in terms of your alcohol intake, think about either not having alcohol, or if you need to have alcohol, think about, okay, what's a low calorie alcoholic drink I can have, rather than, let's say, a pint of lager or a large glass of wine. What can you have? You know, some spirits, you know, some white spirits are going to be obviously a lower calorie option for those people that need some drink when they're out. That might be a good option for you to keep those calories down. And then around that, around those sort of making better choices that day, because you're probably still going to grow your calories, even if you're making a good choice to go out for a meal, you need to think, okay, what can I do the rest of the week to negate some of that calorie surplus I'm going to have on that day where I'm going out for a meal? So can I cut my calories slightly more on those other days? And if I do that, am I still going to be able to maintain good performance in my workouts? Am I still going to maintain sort of a healthy feeling day? Am I going to still feel energized, or am I going to feel like crap? Because if you don't want to get to that point where you're cutting calories so much that you feel like crap, that your body slows down, that's not going to be beneficial either. So you need to really weigh that in. Definitely on the days around when you're going out, though, you can look at cutting those calories around those days. So say you're going Saturday night, you think, okay, on a Friday, I have a few calories on a Friday. On the Saturday, prior to going out, definitely going to have fewer calories to try and negate how much surplus is on that day. And the same on the Sunday, I'm going to just cut those calories a bit more, just to try and balance the effect of you going out. But again, always take into account everything you've had for the week when looking and assessing how successful the diet is going, because you have to look at that and think, okay, I need to really make sure I'm taking into account everything so that I can see, okay, that week I know that I was in a surplus, so therefore I may want to put on weight. Okay, this week I've been good all week, hopefully I've lost some weight this week. We all know that doesn't necessarily work as linear as that. It may be that, you know, it takes a couple of weeks for that to show on the scales. You know, weight loss is not a straight line. If you, you know, the common calculation we've talked about is 3,500 calories deficit will give you a pound of fat loss. It's a bit of a wishy-washy number, a bit of an in the air made up number kind of. It doesn't really work in real life, but If you are consistently good, you will definitely see results. If you are inconsistent, you will struggle to see results. And I think consistency is the key. Take into account for those times when you're out on special occasions. Plan for those throughout the week. And so if you know you've got stuff coming up, put that into account for your weekly food plan, weekly food shop. And just make sure you sort of, you know, you're thinking of calories over a long-term basis rather than just, you know, one day at a time, because that will obviously affect how your fat loss and weight loss is. If you are being really consistent and you're still not losing weight, and you're weighing and measuring, because everything is, people think they're being consistent, but they're not weighing their portion, not looking at their portion sizes, and you really do that, body changing your body composition, especially below something that maybe would be your comfortable weight, your normal weight, is not easy. You do have to be really anal and strict on what you're doing to see significant changes. So if you're doing that, if you're being really consistent, but you're still losing weight, then you need to come and see someone like myself, an expert that can maybe help you out with the way you're exercising, maybe look at what other factors of your lifestyle are affecting it, sleep, for example, hydration, are you on any kind of medication, what supplements you're taking, all of those things can come into it as well. But the key thing is, first of all, to eliminate all the other variables, you need to make sure that you eliminate the variable of your calories. So if you can keep that consistent and then you start exercising for that, then you can see progress. If you're not seeing progress, then you can need to break down and see what the other causes. But tracking calories on a weekly basis and trying to maintain that consistent calorie deficit over the week, over the month, over the year, and you will see, hopefully, some results. Hope that helps, guys. If you've got any questions, please put them in the comments below. I'm happy to answer them either as a comment or I'll maybe produce another video if I feel it merits it. Thanks, guys. Thanks for watching, guys. Please subscribe to the YouTube channel and check me out on Facebook.